There was a look from the Hong Kong players to the umpire just to check that serve was good. Not of approval. Man, it's
match
not
one
been
by
a good day, has it,
Chopra,
for Chan Yung-Lung in particular, out 19, of the mixed doubles, now out of the men's doubles.
16-21, 22-20.
Clever serve from Pranav Chopra. And a topsy-turvy match that swung one way
Chan almost
and then the other. Has gone the way of India. 21-19, 16-21, and then 22-20 in 53 minutes. See, court one lit up with the graphics getting ready for the next match out on court. Hope you're enjoying the action here on day one of this leading BWF World Championship 2014. Fourth time we've been in Denmark for the World Championships. And as you can see, confirmation of that three set match. It saw India on top, and India will be hoping they're on top here in the next match in the men's singles. Kashyap Parupalli up against Germany's Dieter Domka. Up against Domka, a matchup between two players who have played each other quite a lot over the years. In fact, they met as recently as May in Delhi, and it was this man that won. But the other five meetings between them have gone the way of Kashyap, who comes here, of course, fresh from Commonwealth gold, although we saw Michelle Lee enter this court earlier on, fresh from winning Commonwealth Games gold, and she struggled a little bit, didn't she, against Fontaine Chapman. Kasia, former world number six, now dropped down those world rankings. The 27-year-old from Hyderabad, playing in his fifth world championships, but I think last year will be the sorest memory from him in Guangzhou. He had match point in the second game against Du Pengyu, 2019. One more point would have brought him at least the bronze medal, but he lost, and well, it's been a slippery slope ever since, really, for him. I think the hurt of that defeat, coupled with some injuries, really did take him a while to recover. You just wonder whether winning the Commonwealth Games gold medal just a few weeks ago, whether that will be the spur to take him back into the right direction. And he's facing an opponent who's been playing well of late, really. Since beating Kasyap at the Thomas Cup, Dieter Domke has had two events, and he's been in two finals.
Yeah.
Lavrens Bester, our umpire, Eric Kurt there, our service judge. Your feelings on this match, then?
Under the circumstances, I think Kasyap is a little bit, is a favorite here. I think he can maybe in this hall, in this arena, how I've seen it today, can move Dieter around court, so Dieter can't use the height. He's a very tall player and likes to come up and control the mat, so he will be moved more than he normally likes. But then again, that's easier said than done. But I have Kasyap as a favourite.
Yeah, as you saw there, win-loss ratio even, although that doesn't count the Commonwealth Games victories, but he lost in the first round in his last two events prior to Glasgow, Japan and Indonesia. Lost two of his three matches at the Thomas Cup, and as I said, one of them was to this man, Dieter Domke, who's been in good performances lately. Look at that win-loss ratio this year.
Mm.
Very positive indeed. Lost a thriller as well in the European Championships to Janne Jorgensen. It went to the final game, 21. Yeah. 13 in the final game to
and that's
Jorgensen.
That's what I have a feeling about also. If it gets close, I think Kasyap is favourite as well. He lost a very close match at the Brazil also.
Lost in the final, yeah.
To Scott Evans from Ireland. So, and he was, I think he was up two sets. It was with the testing scoring system.
Yeah, the five sets.
So that works a little bit in Kasyap's favour. I don't think the real Kasyap was...
He's like Michelle Lee. He's gone back to India.
But the Kasyap we saw at the Thomas Cup, was not playing well.
Players ready to play.
And as I said, though, but he obviously, then lost in the first round in the next two Super Series events. He's won the Commonwealth Games gold, but we know the level at the Commonwealth Games maybe not quite at the level where, he's having to face this week. But just what that takes out of you mentally, physically, while Domke's preparing for this by playing in a couple of events in Russia and in Brazil. Kasyap's, the high of winning, straight back to training, back in India, then back to Europe again. We'll see. And the carrot is a match against Li Chongwei.
Yeah. Should be interesting.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right,
Kasyap's played in Chongwei a few times, never taken a game off him. Four now meetings.
Catch up, Parapalli, to serve. Level. Play.
And this is.
One. Love.
I think we will see a lot of that soon as Kasyap is on top of the rallies. He will make sure that Dieter has the long run all the time.
Service over, 2-1. Time's over. Two. All.
Such a good reach, hasn't he, Domka? You know, Kasia played a couple of really good shots down the
three,
line, but he just
two.
Seemed totally in control there, didn't he, Domka?
Yeah. And this is where Kasia has to be careful that he just can't give the attack away loosely. Then he'll have way too much time to attack.
Service over. Mm-hmm.
What do you think here, Richard?
Good.
Yeah, I would think so too.
And we were right.
Good call, by the
way. Yeah. One challenge remaining. Service over. Three. All. One. Four. Three.
Yeah, one India's men's gold medal for the first time in 32 years at the Commonwealth Games in July. Beat Derek Wong in the final. Player from Hong Kong. Quarterfinals in the Olympics, quarterfinals in the World Championships last 2 years.
Five,
there's no doubt
three.
His ability. He's a player who's had to battle with various things. We mentioned the injury, but he's he suffers with asthma as well. You wouldn't think badminton is a game in which something like asthma would really be conducive to playing at the top level, but
six,
he's overcome that.
What a safe. That's a great rally.
Positive, hasn't he? Kasia.
Yeah.
It's his kind of game, isn't it, really? He has this jumping style, doesn't he? Say about footballers, don't they? Big footballer's got a good touch for a big man, as if if you're tall you can't have a good touch. But Domka does look very comfortable, doesn't he?
He does.
Eight, six.
But there you see another problem he has, you know, as soon as he's moved quickly from side to side, then his defense is not so good. He almost slipped there and fall backwards, and that's what I think we'll see Kastrup really try to explore. Yeah. As soon as he can see that he's on top, he will move him quickly to the
six.
To the longest point on the floor. So for Dida, it's very, very important to try and take the net and then keep the game so close to him as possible, so make the court smaller.
Isn't it? You wait for the draw, and this is a, you know, not an easy match for either player. And then Edley Chong Wei waits in round two.
And trust me, he waits. He's sitting at the hotel and waiting.
He looked good, didn't he, against Lee Dongqing earlier?
So that's,
you know, you always wonder, don't you, first match back after your injury,
yeah,
how it's going to react. And I suppose,
I think if he had to put a, you know, to have somebody here who wants to play, prefer to play, I think he would prefer to play Dida, who would probably find it very difficult to follow the pace of Lee Chong Wei. But Kastrup more suits his style, so.
Although Kastrup hasn't taken a game of Lee Chong Wei.
I didn't say he was going to do it. It's probably suited more. Unless Dida had taken a game from
I don't think so. No. Not many do.
No.
Is he your favourite to win this week in the men's singles?
Well, from seeing him today, he looks quite on top of his game. So, yeah, I would say that.
You don't feel that?
Oh, great shot.
I don't want you to pile on the pressure on Yana Jorgensen, but
well,
you don't feel that this is...
He has a chance. Of course he has a chance.
I have a sneaky that he might.
You cannot say he doesn't have a chance when he's just won the Indonesian Open. So, for me, that's it right there. No Europeans ever won the Indonesian Open, so
they have now.
Yeah,
so 11-8, the interval lead here for Kastrup. Listen, we can all guess at this stage of proceedings, can't we? Really, but things couldn't be better placed, if you like.
Not
for Jan Jorgensen.
Got one. 20 seconds.
And that's a big, big, big question mark behind Chin Lung's. What is he, you know, which Chin Lung is going to show up?
Well, they said he's changed his training methods a little bit to
play,
try and find the form that he, you know, was in really.
Yeah.
A lot of pressure on him though, isn't there, with Lin down here?
Mm-hmm.
And you can say there's a lot of pressure on Yan because he's playing in front of the home crowd, and you can say there's a lot of pressure on Lee Chong Wei because, you know, he's never won the world title,
and there's about 30 million Malaysians waiting for him to try and win
on Independence Day.
Yeah. So a lot of what can you say, games in the games.
Yeah, and it's whoever can handle that best, really.
That's what sport's all about. But you can see here, Kastrup comfortably going down, placing a clear on the back of the court. You know, that just shows you what he wants to do against Dida. And he can control here. That would be, had that been his doors in iron, where Indonesian Open is played, where there was a lot of drift, and he wouldn't have been able to do that. So it suits his games against Dida way better that he can use the full court there again. Great smash, by the way. So, but it was a good lift. Fantastic smash by Dida Dongqing.
Go.
Yeah, Indian badminton on a high, you know, the Commonwealth Games gold here for Kashyap. The Uber Cup team made the final, of course. One up around Joanna Gutter, won a world championship medal, of course, last year.
Yeah, they've got good youth coming up.
PV Sindhu is a semi finalist. And of course, there's still Saina Nehwal. You still believe she could have a big week this week as well. Just saw the men's doubles, spare win as well.
Yeah.
10-12.
There's no doubt about it, though. Compare this match to the last match. I know it's singles and doubles, but you saw two pairs who found it really hard to win matches, and there were a lot of unforced errors here. You're seeing a lot more winners, two players, you know, one that's just won the Commonwealth Games, one who's just been in two finals in succession, both are high on confidence and feel very attuned to play the shots they have in their armoury.
Making a lot of right decisions, you know, it's a very tactical game right now. Yeah. It's a fantastic match.
14! Day!
Incredible. How quick. You can get around to that round head side.
Yeah.
And that's not easy to put that one straight down. It's easy to go across here. He goes down the line. Fantastic.
Server. 11. 14.
Played. Lovely angle on the racket from Domka there.
14.
He's not afraid to go for a dive, is he, Kashyap? Been the one leading it most of the game, but Domka stuck to the task. ...14-10's become 14-13.
Nice again.
14.
Really going for it, Dieter.
Born in Kazakhstan. But a German, I think he's in the armed forces, part time student as well.
Top.
Oh, that's wide.
15, 14.
Yeah, 43, which is his ranking right now. It's his highest that he's been in the men's singles. And at 26, kind of, say, kind of the age where you're at your prime.
Yeah.
Please welcome the technical officials on court number 4.
I find it a very difficult now right 16. Now, Kasia, because he's Dida is attacking on everything.
6 points in a row, Dom, because just one.
He's just going for it and seems to be very confusing for Kasia.
Their last meeting went 3 games. In fact, their last 5 meetings, going all the way back to 2009, have all gone the distance. Of course, Kasyap had won all of them until the Thomas Cup in India.
I see the difference now is that actually Dida was doing really well in defense on the side. Now Kasyap started to go to the body instead. Because what he can do there is that Dida can't really get that long, so he can just follow up. He knows he's going to come to the net, and from there on he can move him quickly to the corners. Game.
Thank you.
It's 18 minutes old already. Clearer to know who's going to take the initiative here. 17 points all.
Miss hit.
18, 17.
So it went long.
More crucial, that sounds like it should be the case, but with 3 points away from taking the opening game, both these players, that's going to be Kasyap's, of course.
That is a very cool thing to do at 18-all, you know, that backhand cross on the net, this guy's incredible. You read that pretty well.
That is long from Kasyap. It's 19-0.
I'll buy a whisker, she would say.
Yeah. Game point for Kasyap.
20, game point, 90. Play. Play.
Thank you. when he smashed this one.
He's just keeping the attack.
Just felt there was in what I'd call normal points, in other words, games that wasn't game point, you'd have seen Kasyap just be a little more aggressive.
Yeah. But Dida seems to be okay with settling with this, just being in defense. And Kasyap was finding it quite hard to get it down on him, so. Too defensive there, I think. You know, he had chances to take the net away, but he seems to settle for it.
So another game point here for Kasyap. Another pause while the court is mopped.
Thank you.
Okay, I'm good. Tomka. Hanging in, isn't he?
Catch up. Catch up. Did that? Too much walking.
Yeah.
Play must be continuous. Both of you. Stop.
That's a good call.
Okay.
Taking too much time.
Yeah, they're walking around too much. I was thinking about that. Actually, we see a lot of time wasting. Speed up the game.
Done. Saved another game point. And when you consider the court was just mopped as well, so there was time for the players to catch their breath anyway.
It's about who gets the net and that first lift,
21.
And then boom. That's amazing. So quick to that round head side.
Well, game point number 3, third time lucky maybe for Kasyap here. Great disguise. Got it back somehow.
Unbelievable.
Still a little short, should be put away, but he's hanging in, Kasyap. What a point this is. Now can he find a winner?
Nope, not this time. But how did he get that one back in the next one?
Great point. Really was superb.
Oh!
Peter, stay on court. Sorry, Peter.
Don't catch you up. I don't know, has he cut himself? He's got... Yeah, umpires, I think, calling over someone here to have a look. He's pointing to his hip. Was Kasyap after this point?
See, you think he slipped a little bit there. You see, he's actually slipping. He's not falling so much down. And then the next one here, again.
No, how did he call the doctor?
They need the doctor to come.
If he's bleeding, they need the bleeding to stop. He has to have a bandage on or something.
Didn't look like it was bleeding. Looked like he'd grazed it. Looked like it would be sore, but
don't need anything for that. That's just going to sting a little bit when he takes a shower.
Especially, it could be something that's dealt with once this game's over.
Yeah,
there's going to be a.
Well, we don't know how deep it is, but leave him to
sure. Listen, I'm not saying it doesn't hurt at all, but I just couldn't see anything that
thank you, Mr. Referee.
Would need him to stop there and then.
Thank you, doctor. On court. Can he do all?
Well, pause, but let's remember it's 22 points all, and it's a first game point
22.
For the German Domka.
Wide.
It's wide. It's wide. He's going to challenge it.
Yeah.
Is Kasia. But is it a call out of desperation or out of real belief that the line judge has got this one wrong? Because if he has got it right, the line judge, then it's game, Domka.
Oh. That would say that was in. Unless it's the cork.
And we'll see. It's one of those 50-50 ones.
Oh. Gonna go out? No, it's in.
Oh, the tiniest of margins. It's in. Wow.
Oh, that is awful for Dieter Domka.
23-0.
You can't get closer to winning a game and not actually win it.
Oh, my God.
Heartbreaking for Domka. Impossible, really, for the line judge.
That's a great rally again. Oh, that's a beautiful shot by Dieter.
Yeah, wonderful.
And it's so difficult for Kashyap to be in defense 24, there because of the height that Dieter has. So he can actually, you see how far back Kashyap gets now. So he can get up and get that steep stick smash in there, then that opens up the floor for him. So, really, really strong play by the German here after what he just went through
mentally
half a minute ago. We've seen a few of those in there today, huh? It's like Michelle Lee and...
Yeah, and Fontaine Chapman.
Fontaine Chapman. It's the same thing.
Yeah, that one's... He's got to 26 all. Domka has another game point. His third now. Oh, and he's netted it. He has netted it. And it's Dieter Domka who has taken the opening game here. 26-24. Robbed by Hawkeye. Snatched at this one, did the Indian player.
I don't really... It looks really strange that he goes for that one. There's not really a chance to kill it there. It's underneath the net, so maybe a little bit of nervousness.
Oh, what a terrific opening game this was. Kind of had everything, didn't it? It was Kashyap really who was on top for most of it. But after missing out on three game points, it was Domka who took it at his third game point. 26 points to 24.
center. Court one, 20 seconds. Court one, 20 seconds.
Well, some great replays there. A real indication of the terrific action we saw in that first game. It took 32 minutes. You ready for a late night tonight, Jim?
Yeah. Got some very interesting games coming up too, so. Very, very interesting to see how Kashyap is going to come out of this.
Well, you know, in the other games, you know, we felt the Hong Kong pair were... We felt they would come through.
Yeah.
There's nothing in this game so far for me that says either player...
That's no indication.
That either is stronger than the other. They're very evenly matched. I mean, obviously, 26-24, you're going to see that, but... Yeah. It's not now, I think, oh, well, Domka's won that first game. He's going to go on from here. I don't get that feeling. No. Not saying he can't, and he won't, but the scoreline pretty much did reflect what we saw.
But Kashyap just doesn't seem... That interests me a little bit. He doesn't seem to have the weapons to get through to Dida's defense, and therefore he gets really frustrated because he's in the attack most of the time, and then as soon as he wants... to kind of get out of the attack, then Dida is going to come up with shots like this, which is almost impossible to defend.
I mean, we were talking before the game, and I did say to you that I felt Domka had a real chance here today, and that was twofold, really. One was just feel that Kashyap wasn't in great form. Yes, he won the Commonwealth Games gold, but it was kind of against lesser
definitely
opposition. Take nothing away. Terrific, you know, only the third Indian to have won the Commonwealth Games gold in badminton. Drop shot there.
Well, this is the first time we've seen him use that. He's actually only been hitting hard all the time, so maybe that's what we talked about in a bit.
And then you look at Domka's form as well. You know, he's his highest ranking ever. You know, he's playing as good as he could be.
Yeah.
And you look at their previous matches as well together. Five out of the last five have gone to three games.
Oh.
Just long.
Another great rally.
Oh, close.
There, we could really see how difficult it is to defend a shot like that. This one here.
Well, it's also, you know, he went down the line and then immediately you wouldn't know which way it's going to come.
Yeah.
But immediately went cross court.
Second time now.
Yeah.
Maybe he should start using that a little bit more instead of going full attack all the time. Use some better variations from the backcourt there. And you can see that's the tough part for Dida.
But you just wonder if Gopichan's had a little word with him as well.
Of course, for sure.
At the break and said, let's mix it up a bit more. But again, the umpire here just chatting with Kashyap, who he feels is just taking too much time between the points. And I mean, we are 36 minutes into this game. I mean,
they shouldn't need a break. They should be speeding up, I think. You know, it's part of the game.
Five.
Good.
Four.
Good point.
Five.
Oh, he's done it again. Three out of three.
Six.
And now there's going to be some indecision, isn't there, for Domka? You know, if he comes forward and Gashiat plays the smash, he's in trouble.
Yeah.
He won't know which way he's going to go, and it's a good tactic.
It is, definitely is. Oh, good backhand kill.
Turns over. Five, six.
As it was in the first game to Kasyap.
Last chance. All right, last time. Be ready. Be ready.
Well, there's no point in talking anymore. Next time, you got to have the consequence.
Otherwise, you know, it's
the players. You're just going to have more breaks. Yeah. There's not one of these players that doesn't know that he wants to speed up this game, so. Yeah, it's a good kill. He's not over with the racket.
Seven, eight.
Oh, fantastic. Yeah. Great disguise shot.
Ding! Seven!
But nearly every point's a winner, isn't it?
I don't understand why he keeps serving to that side there, why he doesn't try and flick serve or do a high serve catch up, because Dida is just basically pushing it down to the backside, the back of the court, and he's taking the net really steep. So maybe a little bit of variation in the serve would be good from Kasyap. Not that kind from Diva did it there, but.
Well, it's an interval lead again for Kasyap. 11 points to 8. And it's thirsty work out there. Domka, of course, hugely encouraged by how that first game panned out.
Court one, 20 seconds. Court one, 20 seconds.
But you do feel there's an inevitability given their previous encounters. This one is going to go to a third game.
11, 8. Yeah.
Well.
Play.
Apparently they like that. See, this is a short serve again where Dida can go up and either push it or take the net. I think, you know, if Kasyap wanted to get out of that a little bit better, he could start flick serving or just make a high serve just to get Dida out of the rhythm.
Right now.
Turns over.
Always been given out.
Yeah.
11, 13.
Look pretty close. No challenge from Kaschap though. Might have been worth one.
Yeah. Just as you thought Kesha was controlling things, then Dida is back in the game.
He
doubted that one.
12.
Yeah, that was very unlike the way he's played this match.
Controlling the game right now, Kesha. Making Dida run a lot. Those drop shots there, they really hurt Dida from the start. When he started doing that, that's where the game changed around here.
I've got to say, for the last 4 or 5 points, I've just been waiting for the third game to get going.
It looks like that. But Dida has to come up with something with these drop shots because they're really hurting him. He has a long way up there, and it forces him to come further up on court, and then Kaschap can use the back line and the hard smashes. So interesting to see what Dida will come up in that third, because I agree with
13,
you. That's where we're going to go.
Point,
seven game points, and only need one of them there, Kaschap.
Second game, one by
the first game, very tight, very nerving. It was pretty 13, tight here for, we have to say, what, two thirds of this second game, but in the end, it was a stroll at the end for Kaschap. 21 points to 13. And 7 of the last 8 points in that game to Kaschap. Well, for the fifth.
Got one. 20 seconds.
Well, sixth meeting in a row. It's going to a third game between Kasia and Dieter Domka. This has been going on now between them for 5 years. They'll both be aware of that as well, won't they?
Level. Play.
There's some players you can't wait to get out on court and send those shuttles over. There's others whatever's going to happen, whether I win or lose, one, it's going to be a big battle out there.
Yeah.
Fighting hard for the right to play the world number one.
Oh, unlucky. He's got stuck in the net there.
It looks like he's taken a little bit of Dieter's game. But it's just been, as you said, it's that tactical move, wasn't it?
Oh, he's doubting himself. Did he take the challenge back?
Well, he's not challenging, is he?
He did take it back. I think he had his hand in the air, but it's only probably because he realized it was the right call. Effective in this first game, but it's getting more effective now because of the drop shots he's been using, so he's opened up the Dieter's defense.
Oh!
Still got that weapon himself, though, hasn't he? Missed too many of those either. Himself another one, Domka. He's finding a lot of joy with this.
It's kind of funny that Kasia, is not continuing to find that front court there and then wait till this will just happen.
That's
a little bit lucky. He's been quite successful with those strokes, so. That's the flick serve I talked about to get out of that service situation.
Body blowing. Always the one for Kasiap here. Domka taking the early advantage in game three.
Some good defense there by Dieter again.
Too sure, really? Why? Did the umpire say for him to? He could have a break.
I think something.
Six, four, play.
On his hand.
Oh. Smile! Come on!
7-4.
It's a good flick serve. Oh, totally takes Petra by surprise there.
Yeah, perfectly weighted as well. Still wouldn't like to call this one, would you?
No, that's...
Oh!
Incredible by Dida.
No, you know, it's all very well trying to play these shots, but as I say, he really... I can't really think of many he's missed.
No,
he's gone for it.
That's the thing. You know, yeah, he's pretty tall, and yeah, he's, you know, he's a hard hitter, but he's also hitting on the lines. So that's... I think that's fantastic. And it just, you know, there's nothing he can do. Kashyap, there's nothing, there's no way he can get that back. So he knows by now that if his lift is a little bit too short, then pretty much the rally would be over.
6-8.
Only 3 points. It's not a margin to get carried away with.
7-9.
But it's been a really good performance by Domka. Two players.
Top.
Wow, it's a 4-point lead at the interval for the big German Dida Domka. It's been a thriller. We're approaching the hour mark. 11-7 in the final game.
Just have to remember this side was the side where Kashyap was really playing well. So maybe he feels a little bit comfortable on this side, I don't know, because we talked about there's no drift, so it shouldn't really be. But he looked more comfortable in his drops and his clears on this side. So interesting to see if that was just...
Well, here we go, should be an excellent finale to this game.
Points for Kashyap to catch up a little bit. Oh, fantastic. What a feeling.
was he claiming that Domku hit it when it was the wrong side of the net hit?
Well, he might have a case there, I must say. I agree with Casio. That shot was never going to go over. That's a really, really tough match. Who were they playing, you said, in the next round?
Ah, it won't be so hard tomorrow. It's only Lee Chong Wei. Excellent net play from the German dynamo, Dieter Domke. Approaching an hour on court. We're in the 60th minute of this match. And just 2 points separating the players. Still playing top quality badminton.
Oh, great follow up there.
13-4.
One game all, 13-0 it is then. It's Domke who's being the one who's just had his nose out in front here for the majority of this third game.
2-1. A little bit of patience there from Casio, I think. Maybe that's some nerves coming in. Oh, great backhand. Great backhand. Very difficult. He knows Dieter standing at the net waiting for that drop shot that comes there, Luke. Dieter knows that he has to go forward there and still plays it perfectly in.
You know, sometimes you watch two football teams playing in the World Cup, this one's going to penalties.
Yeah.
And you get the feeling with this one, isn't it? You get the feeling extra points could be coming up here as well.
Yeah. Because every time one of them has a lead, the other one's playing good. And then again, you know, you keep changing. Fantastic. But that little thing that having a 2 point gap for Dieter right now, I think is going to be very vital for this match. And especially that he's winning them that easy on the service situation.
Well, 16-17.
Kashyap led 2-love in this third game. Hasn't been in front since then. From Kashyap, comfortably out, and we're back with things dead level again.
Great game. This is fantastic. Just love seeing two players, so different styles, but they're battling constantly.
Coiled spring there as well, the way he leapt back onto his feet. And the goalkeeper would have been proud of that. Excellent net play from Dumka, though. 18-17 now. And a roar of approval as well from the German.
Thing is, Kashyap, we didn't need to go for that net play there. Should have kept it going. Oops.
Hey, he got it back. Two swings in it for Dumka. He can't win this point, then, can he? What a point this would be for him.
What a
match. He's got it, you know.
What a match.
Well, sometimes you look back on a match, don't you? Yeah. That's the point. Is that it?
Incredible.
Look at this again. Missed it, got it. As long as you don't touch the shuttle.
It's a great reaction.
You've got a chance to get to it.
Well, he's, you know, he's got to give him a warning now. You told him not to go out and still goes out and dries himself. You know.
And he's left his towel out now. Yeah. He's got to go back. Chance though to see that again. Whoop, there you go. Got it.
Wow.
And it turns out to be a better shot, doesn't it? Because
yeah, he does know it's coming.
You've bamboozled your opponent.
Yeah.
You couldn't do that on purpose, could you?
No.
Games gold. Kashyap is staring defeat in the first round of these world championships.
Fantastic. Really playing his chances. Dieter should be very proud of his match, no matter how this is going to end up. Tried to flick serve there.
He's done it. Dieter Domke's done it.
Fantastic. Good result for the German.
Yeah, Lee Chong-wei awaits after a wonderful match. Recovered from that second game defeat to take the third. And the difference a couple of weeks makes for Kashyap. From the highs of Glasgow to the low here in Copenhagen. But take nothing away from Dumka, because he played superbly. In fact, both players played very well. It was a really good match. Dumka, the big German, is the one who emerges on top, and the world number one awaits in round two. Confirmation of the scoreline then. 24-26, 13-21. And then in that final game, 21 points to 18.